Hey fellow animators, I'm Miloš Černý, and today I would like to talk to you about why are animation layers useful and why you should use them when animating in any kind of software. In part 1 of this 3-part video, we will take a closer look at absolute layers and how you can use them to their maximum potential. Basically, every software where you can animate has some kind of an animation layer system. I will be explaining it in CAD system in 3ds Max, but most of the information can be applied to other softwares as well. Absolute layers are the basic ones, and you most likely worked with them even if you didn't realize it. When you animate anything, this box for example, you have your timeline where you can see the keys that you placed while making this animation. These keys are actually your first absolute layer. Now let's switch to CAD. I will be explaining it on this 2-leg practice rig done in CAD. If you want to learn more about what CAD is and why is it useful when animating in 3ds Max, you should check out my previous video about that topic. So, when you want to start to animate in CAD, you can't even activate animation mode until you create a layer. So let's create one. You can see that the layer is absolute by this acronym here. And now we can activate animation mode. So what does the absolute layer do? It is basically the individual layer which overrides everything done underneath it. This window here actually represents stack of layers for the selected rig, exactly like in Photoshop for example. It is sorted the opposite way however, but logic is the same. So we have one absolute layer at the moment. Let's animate something simple real quick, a breathing idle for example. Change its name and color. Now if you create new absolute animation layer, you can see that the breathing animation is gone and keys from the timeline disappeared as well. You can now animate something completely different and it will not influence the first animation. Let's do some simple looking around idle. Okay, fine. We have some looking around animated. Let's again rename it and change its color. Now you can switch freely between these two layers however you like. But that is not all though. Let's try and switch bone coloring mode from bones to layers. You see the bones change their color to the color of the layer. When both layers are active, the idle layer is above the breathing layer, which means that idle overrides breathing completely. But by using the local weight parameter, we can tell CAD that we don't want idle layer to override this particular bone chain, in this case the pelvis. So by setting it to 0, we can see the pelvis change the color to that of the layer below. And now, both our animations play at the same time, breathing together with looking around. This is incredibly powerful for blending animations together. You can even animate both values, global weight influences the whole rig and local weight just the selected bone chain. In actual workflow when animating a character for your game for example, you can keep this way several different animations in one max file on your hard drive, usually when they have something in common. For example, all movements like walk, trot and run can be in one movement file instead of three different ones. So that should be it for the absolute layers. If you have any questions about this or that you would like to see something that I didn't cover, leave a comment below. In the next video we will take a look at adjustment layers and how to use them effectively. I am Miloš Černý and thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you want to keep track of the new videos. What topics would you like to see next? Leave a comment or visit my Discord server if you want to contact me personally via instant messaging about anything. Thank you.